Good morning everyone. So today our topic will be animal nutrition. This is the lecture 2 of live processes for class 10th. So topics which will be covered are heterotrophic nutrition and its types, steps of holozoic nutrition in amoeba, and human nutrition. Now starting with heterotrophic nutrition. Types of heterotrophic nutrition. So heterotrophic, you all know, is the nutrition in which organism depend on other organism for its food. And basically it's of three different kinds: holozoic nutrition, saprozoic nutrition, and parasitic mode of nutrition. So holozoic nutrition is coming from a word, whole is derived from the word whole, means complete, and zoo means animal like. So any organism, if it is taking the food in animal like manner through its mouth like structure or mouth, proper mouth, then its nutrition is known as holozoic nutrition. Sapro means dead matter. So if any organism, any animal is taking food from dead matter, then we say that it is saprozoic mode of nutrition. Parasitic is the nutrition in which the parasite named organism depends on its host for living, for its food and shelter. Example, if we take the example here, all animals are mostly higher animals. Higher animals like us, human, are having holozoic nutrition. Protozoas are having holozoic nutrition. Saprozoic nutrition, here organism which depend on other organism, dead matter basically, like fungus. So fungus is having saprozoic nutrition. Few protozoans are there which show saprozoic nutrition. Parasitic example, tapeworms, which are intestinal worms which live in the human intestine, are showing parasitic mode of nutrition. Now steps of nutrition in amoeba, or we can say steps of heterotrophic nutrition. Steps of heterotrophic nutrition can be seen with the help of a protozoa known as amoeba. This is amoeba, it is irregular shaped organism. If there is any food which is present inside its surrounding, it is going to come near to that food through its cellular motion, and then will try to engulf the food through finger-like projections called as pseudopodia. It will cover that food around, it will cover the pseudopodia around that food. And this step, first step, is known as ingestion. Now, this food will go inside the amoeba inside a food vacuum. Here is a nucleus, and there is a structure which is made having the food called as food vacuum. Now amoeba cytoplasm is going to secrete various enzymes inside this food vacuum, and the second step will start, which will known as digestion. So food will be broken down into this food vacuole into tiny fragments. by the action of enzymes. And this is cytoplasm of amoeba. And now, when the food is very simpler, divided into simpler substance, now the third step will start, which is known as absorption. Now the food will diffuse, the absorption occurs by diffusion. So food will diffuse to outside the food vacuole into the cytoplasm. And the amoeba will be growing in size, it will be using it for its own growth. So this is the fourth step, assimilation. That means the food is used by amoeba. And now whatever waste are there will be collected at corner and will be blasted to outside the amoeba. This is known as the last step, fifth step, called as egestion. So this is the removal of waste. We can say waste food. So this is egestion. So this is the five, these are the five steps. Number one, ingestion. Number two, digestion. Number three, absorption. Number four, assimilation. And number five, egestion. Now we are going to understand about the human nutrition. You can easily understand human nutrition by the line diagram. That what happened to us when we take the food in our mouth. So this is our oral cavity in which there is tongue, in which there are teeth, and there is nasal cavity around the nose also. There are two pipes which are there. One is the windpipe, which is forward, and the other one is the food pipe, which is downward at the back side. There are few glands in the mouth as well, which are known as salivary glands. Salivary glands are there in oral cavity, in mouth. And then the food pipe will extend into a J-shaped structure, muscular bag-like structure called as stomach. And in the front of the stomach, there will be a triangular structure called as liver. And behind or below the stomach, there will be a leaf-like structure called as pancreas. So pancreas and liver both will release their own juices into this U-shaped structure called as duodenum. This is the first part of the small intestine. So these both structures, pancreas and liver, are transferring its liquid here in the duodenum. And then this is going behind, and in front the area is covered by large intestine. And behind this is going as continuation, deeply folded small intestine. It is going to join through the large intestine. So thank you. So finally, there will be rectum, and at last there will be anus. So this is human digestive system by which human are able to digest, or we can say humans are able to do their nutrition. So in them also, ingestion starts in the mouth. First step starts in the mouth, where the starch present in the food and that to 2 to 8% only get acted upon by salivary amylase. Means this enzyme is present in the saliva, so it is getting converted into maltose, a simpler form. And then the food goes down inside the food pipe, and it is going inside the food pipe through a particular contracting, relaxing rhythmic wave called as peristalsis. Now the food will be going inside the stomach. Here the food will be acted upon by the gastric juices. So next digestion, first digestion started in mouth of starch. Now second digestion will be started by gastric juice, which will be of proteins. So here proteins will be acted upon by gastric juice. What is there in the gastric juice? Gastric juice is having three things. One is HCl, other thing is pepsin, and other thing is mucus. So proteins are digested by the enzyme called as pepsin into peptones, small fragments, and peptides. Still these are proteins, but these are small fragments of proteins. Now coming to the action of liver. So what role liver is doing in digestion? Liver is producing a greenish, yellowish fluid called bile. Although it is not a digestive juice, but it is having somewhat properties like detergent. It acts as an emulsifier for fats. So big fat molecules are converted in the presence of bile into the small fat particles. No fat digestion is taking place, just the fragments are getting small. So the fragments are getting small. Now the action of pancreas. Now what is the action of pancreas? So in pancreas, pancreas is releasing three enzymes in its juice. What are those three enzymes? It is trypsinogen, or we can call it trypsin. It is one other is amylase, pancreatic amylase. Amylase and lipase, pancreatic lipase. Now these three enzymes, the trypsin is a protein digesting enzyme. So proteins are going to be acted upon by trypsin into peptones, small fragments, and starch will be again acted upon by amylase, pancreatic amylase, into maltose. And small fats, now the fats are converted into small fats. So it is acted, it can be easily acted upon by lipase and converted into fatty acids and glycerol into its products. So this lipase is the, we can say, fat digesting enzymes. Now the food will go, is inside the small intestine, and now the intestine, small intestine will also release its gas, we can say digestive juices. Now we will be studying the action which is taking place into the small intestine. So small intestine, here in small intestine it releases large number of digestive enzymes. Leading to completion of digestion. Here the digestion will finally be completed. Completion of digestion. So what are those enzymes? Like if maltose is there, so it will release maltase enzyme. And maltose is going to be converted into two glucose molecules. So it will be finally broken down. It is a final product of the digestion of carbohydrates. Now peptones and peptides. So this is also acted upon by peptidase enzymes. So it is going to convert into amino acids, which are the final monomer units of proteins. Now coming to nucleic acids, like DNA, RNA of the food materials which we have eaten, they are also acted upon by nuclease enzymes, and it is converted into nucleotides. Which is the monomer of nucleic acids. This is how the complete digestion will be taking place. Now, one more function of the small intestine is important to note over here, is that when the digestion is completed at this level, then the absorption of food, which is the third step of digestion, nutrition, is the absorption. It also occurs in the small intestine. So absorption occurs in small intestine. Small intestines are 2 to 4 meters long, longest we can say in the herbivores, and they are deeply folded and packed inside this abdomen area. So its function is basically absorption. And how they are doing so? Because each small intestine, if it is there, its diameter is small but its function is very big. Inner surface of the small intestine is deeply folded and is having many tiny finger-like projections. These finger-like projections are like this, called as villi. These villi are there in the inner lining of small intestine. So inner lining of small intestine is having villi. So these villi are internally richly supplied with the blood vessels. What are those blood vessels? Like they can be richly supplied by the arteries and veins. And one more vessel is there, which is there called as lymph vessel. So this lymph vessel is also there, which will be helping in the absorption of fat. Fat absorption. And other are the blood vessels which are there. So these villi's, finger-like projection of the inner lining of small intestine, is going to absorb the food. When the food is around these villi's, the food, the glucose present in the food, the amino acids present in the food, the nucleotides present in the food, which we have just studied in the previous step, they all get easily get diffused into our blood vessels. So blood vessels get that substances. So this is known as absorption. So third step is, I hope third step absorption is clear with you. Now, after absorption, when the substances are present in the blood, now assimilation will occur. This is the fourth step and the second last step of human nutrition. Assimilation, how it occurs? Now the blood vessels are there in blood vessels will supply, blood vessels are supplying nutrition to whole body. Whole body, therefore all tissues will get the food supply. And they will grow by consuming that food. This step is known as, this is called assimilation. So body will assimilate that food into its cells. Body will use that food in growing, reproducing, repairing, maintaining itself. So this is assimilation. Now coming to the next, the ejection. The last step of nutrition in human is ejection. The waste food through peristalsis now move into large intestine lined by villi that help absorption of water and salts, some salts over there. And lastly, the food will be and the waste is transferred for temporary storage in rectum until it is released to outside through anus. So the food will be finally will be defecated outside. This final step of human nutrition is ejection. So the waste will be there inside this large intestine and it will be temporarily stored over here in the rectum and then lastly it will be released through the anus. The waste will be released through the anus. So this is the human nutrition. I hope this is clear with you. Thank you.